वनकम, मैं हैदर अली सैयद आशीर्वाद से यूनाइटेड अंडर तमिल सेवा।
हाय, दिस इज वेंकट राघवन फ्रॉम नंगनल्लूर। सर, वन मोर क्वेश्चन आउट ऑफ माय क्यूरियोसिटी, सो इट इज माय वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन फॉर सो मेनी इयर्स, बिकॉज आई वाज इन मीडिया, दैट इज प्रिंटिंग मीडिया एंड आवर सोशल मीडिया, सर दे आर एक्चुअली एक्टिव ऑन दिस पार्ट, दे एक्चुअली कनेक्ट एवरी बैड थिंग्स विद ओनली टू रेस, ओनली इज ज्यूइश रेस एंड अनदर इज ब्राह्मिन रेस। Why they actually blaming these two races? Actually, they live in very small population, but for every cause they are blaming them. What is the reason behind it? Is this any agenda, hidden aspect of anything like that?
See, actually, Brahmins earlier days, when Persian they came and migrated and settled in the Iranian plateau and Indus Valley, they appointed a Brahmins as an agent in India, as a spy, to take control, keep an eye on the elites of the colony all over the India. This was the basic thing. Earlier they were there, but now people are, they are not following, they are not still agent of those Persians. Today, the main agenda is the Roman Empire and Persian Empire. They are running the whole show. Varnadharam is followed by them, Shia, Sufi, Sunni, they are following it. And in India, Brahmins are used as a punching bag. Out of about 100 people, 20 people are still working for Persian agenda, but 80% are used as a punching bag. But if you look into other Islamic organization, Dawa organization, they are going against Quran and they are following Varnadharam, Manu law. So they are 100% into following Varnadharam.
So you are telling directly the following the footprints of Varnadharam,
like more children, early age marriage. This is a part of, it's not nothing to do with Islam. If you look into prophetic way of life, Ibrahim,
yeah, it's very simple.
Ibrahim, 99 years having children, Prophet Muhammad marrying 45 years old, yeah, woman and twice married. These are all because these people wanted quality, not quantity.
Okay. Even though they need one son, that one son should be
quality one.
Qualified person.
Qualified and not quantity, quality.
Qualified person. That qualified, is having, yeah, quality.
Quality with all the emotions should be eliminated. But Varnadharam needs mouth. They want more people. So now Brahmins are more close to Asivagam than the Muslims themselves. They are not Muslims. No Muslim reads Quran. They don't understand Quran. They are just following Bukhari Hadith, and Bukhari is what? From Persian clan. So they are following Manu law.
No, sir, I don't have any knowledge about Bukhari, yeah, and all, but I, yeah, know, yeah, I read Quran in my Tamil
so
language.
Quran is related to Asivagam. And Bukhari and Muslim are from Persian clan, whom Prophet Muhammad never entertained. And today, all Muslim organization, political organization, they are not ready to leave Varnadharam. So why blame Brahmin for that? See, Asivagam gives power to people.
Okay, that is like empowerment of women, like that, how Periyar,
yeah,
has to work.
Yeah,
so empowerment of self-soul.
In administration sector.
Okay.
Because Asivagam, everyone has to be present at the Koel.
Koel concept you already explained.
Koel is nothing but parliament or house of a king. And they have to take active part in administration. If any rules and regulation has been passed, they have to approve that.
Okay.
But today people are working like how Mahabharata, ruling and opposition are raping India. Draupadi, they are ruling and they are silent. Why blame Brahmin for that?
Okay, you are also a supporter of Brahmin then now, for your perception.
See, I am not supporter of anything, but the thing is that people should stick to dharam, whether it be of any race or any, they should be with truth, dharam.
Okay.
The battle is between dharam and adharam.
Okay, already you told.
Yeah, so we have to be with dharam.
It is not from now, actually it is immemorial, yeah, time, where the fight is between, yeah, truth and actually always against truth.
When we are following Varnadharam, why blame Brahmin for that? If in political thing, we are not giving power to people, we are converting them, you ask God for that. They are not giving the rights to people. They are stealing their rights. So why blame God for that, or why blame Brahmin for that? What Brahmins have done? Persian have started an agenda. They first giving contract to Brahmin. Now all the Muslim organization are following that, converting them. And even Christian organization, the Christian, they say establish a kingdom of God. Just saying God, 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 will the kingdom of God will be established?
No, first we have to follow the commandments of
commandment,
Christ, right?
Nah. So nobody is interested in commandment. They want Manu law and they want to talk about God. and then they want to blame Jews and Brahmins for that.
But they told Jewish are the hidden secret society, they are called Illuminati, like that. Lot of social media people are also now speaking in that way.
First syndicate of elite is between native and settlers. That was in India. See, earlier Brahmins were involved in this syndicate, but now we have this syndicate of global elites, and the problem is between native and settlers. And the hypocrites among the natives who for some money, power, they are helping the wrong agenda. And this is not pertaining to India also. Everywhere, in America, in Africa, everywhere. Few hypocrites among the natives, they are helping the syndicate. Even Europe also.
So they want to establish New World Order.
New World Order. So it's just a few handful of people. Like in Quran it says, blessed race, cursed DNA, and astray people. Okay. These are the astray people.
You told fugitive is the right word, right?
Yeah, astray people are nothing but the New World Order. Earlier it was an old syndicate run by Brahmins. Now Brahmins are not a part of that. It's only the New World Order headed by Saudi, American dollars, and the Italian mafias. They are making the syndicate, and because of them, all the natives, whether it be Europe, whether it be India, whether it be anywhere, the natives are in problem. See, going back into history, after Prophet Muhammad, settlers are not allowed to enter Hijaz area. And from 7th century onwards to 15th century, it was the royal bloodline of David, tribe Judah, more. They governed the Hijaz area plus Africa. And the 700 years, Spain was ruled under the Moors. This was the first thing. In 15th century, Uthmans entered into Hijaz area. And the governor was appointed in Hijaz area, and the people, the more the black people were not allowed to into power. In the 19th century, with the help of the locals, the British overthrew the Ottoman Empire from the thing, and then British gave power to Saudi. And Saudi and Saud family, Wahab family and British, they genocide the natives, the black people from family of Ibrahim, around about 88 lakh people. Officially is recorded that they genocide people, they cut off their hands and leg, and many of them fled from Hijaz region. And then ultimately Saudi took over the two holy mosques, and they commercialized the Hajj with the help of Uthman and Iran, Iraq, all these other settlers. And then after a few years they got oil, and with the oil they, with the help of America, They started, because Saudi was in that period facing problem from Africa also, black people also, from Ottoman Empire also, and from Iran also. So he needs some security guard, and he appointed America. And since oil came there, so he protected, it was like a give and take policy.
As per your answer, so the own people, that is the native peoples, are being betrayed by them.
Saudi is not a native. The real Arabs are black.
Okay, so the Arabs people only, they got betrayed from them. Huh?
No. The Saudis are settlers.
Settlers, okay.
So Saudis are settlers, native. But the New World Order currently, which we are facing today, the today problem is that all the local people, whether he be a settler, whether he be a mixed race, or whether he be a Aryan, we have been bullied by the New World Order. And they are blaming Brahmin for that.
Okay, they just need a tag, that's it.
Yeah, they need, but they are hiding behind the Brahmin and Jew label. The main culprit, the Saudi, the American dollars and the Italian mafias, they are hiding their face.
So in Tamil we have proverb, Pasunthol Porthiya Puli. So that is the right term we can tell in Tamil, no? So, we are talking about Shiva, Tamil. So yeah, we have to use the proverb
like
for that.
Handful of Jew in Jerusalem and handful of Brahmins in India, they are a punching bag for the New World Order.
So they use this tag and they protect themselves. Okay.
See, in India we have around about 70% black population and mixed race. Brahmins are hardly a few percentage. If we can destroy those few percent, will we be able to live in peace?
No, it is actually against God's commandment. You should not destroy anyone.
But for example, since the elites of the natives are running their show in the Varna Dharam, so who is more near to Varnadharam, Brahmin or the ruling and opposition parties?
Okay, so now the Indian politics is played by New World Order,
New World Order, and Varnadharam is being, because the rulers, they don't want common people to take part in active politics.
Okay. Actually, Shiva belongs to actually Dravidian race only. They will tell.
Dravidian is not a race. It's a language. Race.
It's a language.
All people are speaking Tamil language. Dravidian language just came after the invasion of after the coming of Aryans. Mixing of Sanskrit and
Tamil.
Tamil, the Dravidian language came into, and Sanskrit also got into written form with the help of Tamil people only.
Well, that is true, eh?
Yeah. Vanakkam. Thank you.